Welcome to video lesson 5.4, where we will be talking about terminating and repeating decimals. You can fill this out in your table of contents. We are on page 59 today and title it just our topic, terminating and repeating decimals. You are going to need your blue sheet, so make sure you have that ready. Now, before we talk about these ideas of terminating and repeating decimals, I want you to take your note sheet. I know mine's white and yours is blue, but I want you to fold it in half. That will help us find the middle. And then you're going to actually open it up so that the typed notes are back on the table. And you're going to fold both edges towards the center, like so. So it'll open up like a book. And this is mine all done. And you're gonna glue that down so that your flaps will be folded like so. And we're gonna do some examples on the inside and take notes on the outside. So you've heard this word terminate, which is in the word terminating. I just wanna give some real life examples for you to wrap your head around what this word might mean. So to terminate could mean in the employment world or job world that you are not working anymore. You are fired or you have a termination notice. You have a contract perhaps that is canceled or stopped. That's another real life situation. Obviously the terminator put a stop to bad things, sure. And exterminator, if you look at that word that has the word terminate in it, an exterminator gets rid of unwanted pests or things like that. So those are just some words to associate for you and give some meaning to this word terminate. And now let's talk about the math word terminating. So the math version of this, we actually want to revisit in your notes this page where we talked about kinds of numbers. Remember, we've been talking about integers for a while now, and those include whole numbers, zero, and negative numbers. A bigger picture of those numbers also include any rational number. So that's what we're really going to be working with over the next couple days. Terminating decimals are the decimal form of a rational number where you have a repeating digit of zero. I'm going to show you what that means with these examples below, already done for you. And this, I want you to write underneath this box, this decimal, technically you could add a zero to the end of that and it wouldn't change the value of the decimal at all. In fact, we could add as many zeros as we want all the way to infinity and never stop going. And this repetition of zero means that you could cut off all those zeros. You don't need to have the zeros. That's what terminating means. It can be cut off and it doesn't change the value of the decimal at all. So we can simply just say, hey, this is just 25 hundredths. The same happens with 0.2. Again, in money, we would want to put that zero in the hundredths place to deal with 20 cents. We could deal with 200 thousandths. That's the same number. We could go all the way and keep going. But we don't have to. We want to be able to make it shorter so that we're just dealing with this 0.2 or 2/10. And let's do another one just for kicks. This 125 hundredths. We could add zeros repeating to the right, but we can cut it off as well and have it stop after the five because the rest of them are zeros and it doesn't change the decimal at all. So that's what terminating decimals are. I'm just going to go over the steps. And this is a review, except for this sign thing, because we are going to be dealing with positive and negative rational numbers now. So whatever the sign is, you're going to keep it the same. Keep the sign of the rational number the same. So if it's a positive number and you're being asked to find its decimal equivalent, it will be positive, and vice versa if it's negative. Remember, if you are finding the decimal equivalent of a fraction, you're going to do long division, and you're going to put the numerator inside the division sign, and then the denominator goes on the outside. And you will have to annex zeros. You will be able to check with calculators. How do you do that? This is the calculator key. Whatever the numerator number is, you put into the calculator. Then you hit the division symbol. Then you add whatever number the denominator is. And then in our yellow calculators, we would then press enter, which is the equal sign. And that decimal that you get is the decimal equivalent. So I am done filling out this inside. Now I'm going to move on to the inside and talk about repeating decimals, and then we'll do some examples. So like I did with terminating, here's just some real life associations. You can bring meaning to the word repeating. Obviously it repeats over again. Like Amy Simon says, cool thing, patterns are all around us, and repeating patterns are what we're gonna be talking about in math. So in the math side of repeating decimals, it is a decimal form of a rational number, so same as the terminating, but it has a pattern of repeating digits this time. And it doesn't mean that it's the zero repeating all the time. So repeating digits that continue on indefinitely. That's why I have this infinity symbol down here. It can go and continue on and on, just like those zeros will, but they won't always be zeros. There'll be a pattern to it. So before I talk about bar notation, sometimes the repetition is with two numbers, sometimes it's just with one number, and sometimes there's more than two numbers. So let's talk about how to show that repetition now with bar notation. Bar notation is a bar or a line, both of those, that is placed only over the digits that repeat. If you notice this example, A, the 1 and the 2 do not repeat, only the 5, 3, 5, 3, 5, 3. So the bar, the line, is just above the 5 and the 3. B example, the whole number is there. Notice it's on this as well, but the decimal part repeats every three digits. So 752, 752, 752. So that's why the bar is across all three of the numbers. Like I said before, it could be just one number repeating. And so in this case, it's 22 and a third. This three you've seen before as a repeating decimal, and that three has the bar over it. The steps for repeating decimals are pretty much the same. You're going to keep the sign of the rational number the same, just like before. It's a negative, it's going to be a negative. And when you divide, this is the long division way, numerator and denominator, same thing. But I want you to look for patterns in the remainders. That will give you a clue that, ooh, the dividends, the number in the answer, is going to repeat as well. If you're looking, doing a calculator, you're just seeing the dividend in the display, so you're going to want to look for repetition in the dividend. And be careful, make sure you know whether it's one number repeating or if there's a pattern, two numbers or even more. I do have quite a few examples that I wanted to do with you to get you used to working with this concept. So if you want to picture these columns as four columns and doing two on each column, that will be a spatial help for you to kind of figure out where in that middle section you can do any, starting at the on the left and going over to the right to do your example. So the first one, we're going to start off kind of easy, is, and you are going to have to label this example one in your big blank piece of paper. It's going to be a negative 7/10. I'm writing it the way fractions will be more easily able to be worked with, and that's going to equal a negative decimal. So I already know my answer is going to be negative. I can put that in before I even do anything. Then I can work with 7/10 and not forget that it's going to be a negative. So that I do first. Now I'm going to divide 7/10. This will work out and will be a zero in the remainder. Whenever you have a zero in the remainder, that tells you it's a terminating or ending decimal. I could put a zero here, and I could go to town and just put a bunch of zeros, but I don't need to. It's going to terminate or end at that 0.7. So that's our one example of a terminating decimal. We've done a lot of terminating decimals where we get a zero in the remainder, and we're done. It works out evenly. Sometimes what we've done in the past, we might have to annex zeros, and it would maybe be 0.725. That is a possibility, but it will still end at that 5, and that's also a terminating decimal. So whenever you're dividing and you get a zero, you know that it's terminating. So right below example 1, you can put example 2. And that is going to be a negative 2/9. And what is the decimal equivalent? Again, first thing, is it positive or negative? Write that sign in so you don't forget that it will be a negative decimal. Then we're just going to take 2/9, divide numerator by denominator, annex zeros. So to start with, we have, what times 9 gets you close to 20? 9 times 2 is 18. When we subtract, we will get 2. If we annex another 0, that is a 20. The only thing that works is another 2, which is another 18. And when you subtract, there's another 2. So if you see, this is a pattern in the remainders. I'm always getting a 2 when it's turning into a 20 when I drop down that next 0. And I can continue the same pattern, and lo and behold, I will get another 2, which will turn into a 20. So when you see in your remainders that you start getting the same number, that's the clue that whatever your numbers are in the dividend, those are going to be repeating. Our answer is going to be 2 repeated. So this example is actually going to be a little bit harder in that our dividend is not going to be just one number repeating. So example 3, is in the next column, we're going to set it up. 2/11 is equal to what? Now it's a positive number, so we don't have to worry about any negative sign. We are just going to divide 2 by 11 and annex those zeros. So here's the decimal point. We're going to put that in first. And we have a 20 to start off with. 1 times 11 is 11, and then if I bump it up to 2, it's 22. That's too high. So the only thing I can do is 1 times 11. When I subtract this, I get a 9. Okay, I don't see anything yet. 2, 9. Let's annex a 0. We have 90. 11 times 8, 88. That's as close as we can get. When I get that and subtract, I will get a 2. Let's annex another 0, and I'm getting a 20. Ooh, I'm noticing a pattern already, but I want to make sure that it's going to continue. So I have to do this a few times to get to see if there's a repetition. So I'm getting another 20, which means it's another 1. 20 minus 11 is the same thing we did up here. I'm going to get another 9. When I annex another 0, I'm going to get another 90. And I'm going to get another 8. And when I subtract 88 again, I'm going to get another 2, which will turn into another 20. So this pattern, you look at the remainders, I have a 90, a 20, a 90, and a 20. So the remainders are repeating, which tells me the numbers up here in the dividend will go back and forth, 1, 8, 1, 8, 1, 8. When we write this as a number with a bar notation over it, we're just going to use 1, 1, and 1, 8, and the bar goes over both numbers to say that those two repeat. Now I'm going to take it a step further and see how more complex that it could be when you're trying to find the decimal equivalent. So example 4 is going to be 5/12. Again, a positive number, so we know our decimal equivalent is going to be a positive number. 5 divided by 12 is what we have to do now. Let's put in our decimal point.
and annex our zeros.
We're going to start out with 50. 12 times what gets you close to 50? I know 12 times 5 is 60. That's too much. 12 times 4, though, is 48. So we're going to start with that. 48 is 2 away from 50. So when we subtract and borrow and trade and do all that jazz, we get a 2. We have to annex another 0, and we get 20. 12 times 2, 24. That's too high, so I'm going to do a 1 and get a 12. Well, we subtract, I'm getting an 8. I don't see any patterns right now. I've had a 5, a 2, and an 8. Let's keep going. I have an 80. So 12 times 6, we said, was, 12 times 5 is 60. 12 times 6 is 72. That's going to be as high as we can get to the 80. So we have 72 as what we're subtracting from 80. When we do that, we will get another 8. If we then have another 0, we would have another 80, then another 6, and another 72. When we subtract, we get another 8. Here's where we're seeing the pattern now. We didn't see it for the first two numbers, but now we're seeing this 8 show up, this 8 show up, and the third one. And it turns into 80, and then we do the 6, and then we subtract, and we get another 8. So just this part right here starts to repeat, just the 6. So sometimes you'll have in your answer the tenths place doesn't repeat, the hundredths place doesn't repeat, and only the thousandths place repeats. So just another different situation that you could see when you're dividing. I know these seem to be a lot of examples, but as you're seeing, you could get different answers depending on what fraction you're asked to convert to a decimal. So this example, example 5, is a mixed number. So something new again. So we have a negative 4 and 2/3. In the beginning, we can transfer the negative over and the whole number. And now all we have to deal with is this 2/3. That's going to make it a lot easier. You don't have to put it into an improper fraction or any of that. Just take the whole number, plop it in the ones place, see if it's negative or positive, and then take the fraction piece and take care of that as a decimal. So 2/3, this might have been one that you actually memorized. It is great. This is going to be a repetition of a 6. And when we subtract, we get a 2 right away and get another 20 and another 18. And we see this pattern immediately where the 2 here, here, and here is repeated. We want to see it at least a couple or three times to know that that is the pattern. That 6 will repeat. So our decimal is going to be just that 6 with the bar notation over it. Example 6 is going to be a negative 2 and 5/6. And you can go ahead and do this one. This is just another practice problem, nothing fancy. We've done examples with it that are similar. Just try it out yourself and then come back and you'll see if you're right. So notice I have the negative 2 already over on my answer line, and I'm just dealing with 5/6. I have divided enough so that I see the pattern of these 2s. 2, 2, 2. And you can stop after 3, and 3 meaning 3 times it comes up in the pattern. And my decimal is going to be one number that did not repeat at all, but those 3s went on and on and on and on. So hang tight, we have 2 left, and they are a little bit more complex, so I want us to persevere through them so that we're prepared for anything that I might throw at you tomorrow. Example 7 is going to be the whole number 9, and then we have the fraction 8 over 55. Notice the denominator is a little bit bigger. So right away I'm going to put the 9 in the ones place. Now I just have to deal with 8 over 55. And this is a case where you might have to work a little bit harder to see the pattern. We're going to start off by going 1. And when we subtract, it's going to be a 7 and 25. When we annex the 0, it becomes 250. Now, I know you might not know your 55 facts. That's okay. 55 times 5 is going to be 25 to 275. That's a little too high. So 55 times 4, it's going to be 220. That will work. So we're going to use the 4 and subtract 220 away from it, and we're left with 30. I have not seen any patterns so far. I'm going to keep annexing my zeros. I have a 300. 55 times 5, we already figured out, was 275. So I'm going to use that 5. And we're going to annex the, we're going to put the 275 below and subtract. When we do, we get a 25. Annexing a 0, now we have a 250. Ooh, I like this because I saw 250 up here. Now I'm seeing it down here. Yay, this is the beginning of a pattern. So we are going to need our 4 again. We're going to need our 220 again. And yay, we get a 30, which turns into 300, just like it did up here. So now we have officially seen that the 5 and the 4, the 4 and the 5, we're going to repeat over and over and over again. Because when we subtract our 220 out, when we subtract our 275, out, we will get another 25. So sometimes you have to keep annexing zeros until you see this pattern. And our decimal will be 9.145 with the line just over the 4 and 5. Last one, I promise. This one is very important because it's different than all the rest. I'm giving you a context and this phrase right here, out of. Whenever you see that phrase, 34 out of 44 free throws, you know that you're dealing with a fraction. So on your paper, you don't have to write this whole thing out. Just on example 8, I want you to write out of is that fraction bar. Okay? So whatever number is before the out of, that's the numerator. Whatever number is after the out of is the denominator. So we want to take this fraction and put it into a decimal. So I'm going to let you do this one on your own. I'm not going to give you the answer. Come to class with the answer to see if you're right. I look forward to seeing you then, where we will be dividing like crazy to convert fractions to decimals and see which ones are terminating or ending and which ones are repeating. See you then. Bye.